you know, there's the formal way of doing program project management, and we can't neglect that. But I think what Thomas and I are going to try to give you a chance today is to think about some of those other things that are beyond kind of the published things, and things that can make the difference between a project being successful and having problems. And the first one you described is actually the paying attention to the people. So not just looking at the metrics and look at the data, but actually spending the time with the teams, interacting with the teams, so you really know what's going on with the program or project. At the beginning, you're doing the assessment to make sure you kind of get the requirements right. Then you go through, can you design the hardware, the preliminary design review, and then you go to critical design review when you're actually ready to go into manufacturing. And I think kind of the message there is throughout those various cycles, there's tools that are more effective in one phase that are not maybe quite as effective in another phase. So I think you need to adapt your management style and be aware that your project is changing through these phases and look for different ways of doing business. Yeah, in a couple of our projects and programs, we're getting right into that big assembly integration and testing. You know, we're there with Orion. We're about ready to receive the European service module from the Europeans and from Bremen here in November. And then it goes into the Kennedy Space Center, gets integrated with Orion, gets shipped to Cleveland for testing. And that's about a 400-day period of just fairly intensive assembly integration. We look at that schedule, we've laid it out as a 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-week activity for that entire 400 days. And that all fits in the schedule, it all looks good. But reality is, stuff is gonna break. Do you need some time in there to catch up, right? So what we're now struggling is maybe we actually schedule in breaks during this whole 400-day period where we're gonna have a couple days of downtime. So if the work slips, it doesn't ripple into the next activity, keeps other teams waiting around. It actually gives you some margin to keep things going. The first time through is much, much longer. And I talk about it as a learning curve. But that learning curve really comes down on the second and third times. You can really start homing those procedures. You know what fits and what moves forward. So I think that you just got to factor that in and not be discouraged when that's occurring. But then take that learning from one individual activity and then say, okay, don't just assume all the other work instructions stay static and you don't change them. Continue to learn from what you saw before and make changes back and forth. So I think sometimes we remember the things that really went bad, but then we don't remember some of the things that really went well. And we should capture those things that really went well and make sure that those get shared just as much as the things that went bad. You need to really create an environment where folks are willing to be open and transparent, and they're also willing to take challenges. It's truly an art, because you want to put pressure on them, you want to hold folks accountable, you want to provide tough love, you want to push them to do new things, but also you don't want to be so hard on them that they're afraid to do anything or they don't disclose to you when something is not going right. You need that open environment. So I think there's a bigger negative side of not sharing data than there is of sharing data. I have folks from the Orion team looking at commercial crew. I got commercial crew folks looking at the Orion team, SLS teams, et cetera, in these independent reviews. And really what I'm doing is I'm trying to raise the level of expertise in program project management by letting these folks get to see different projects, different programs, and different phases of life cycles. And it makes them carry extra work, but I think it's a really positive way of improving the overall knowledge and moving forward.